Hello everyone, welcome back to Vintage. We've been having a lot of fun launching City on Fire into the world. I shared with you some links last week when I was talking about the book, and I have more for you this week, because when Garth Riz-Kallberg was over in the UK, I managed to grab him and do a podcast interview with him. And obviously, with such a big book, we had a lot to talk about, and I could quite happily have talked to him all day, frankly, because there was lots to discuss, and he's a whip-smart guy, and he's very interesting, very cool, and so we had a lot to talk about. I have managed to edit it down to a sort of manageable chunk. So it's about 40 minutes long, and I'll put a link to it in the description below. You can download it so you can listen to it whenever you have the time, or on your train, or sort of when you've got a quiet moment at home. But I really encourage you to listen to it because, as I say, he's a smart guy, he's really interesting, and I was intrigued to see exactly why he'd written the book and what had gone into the writing of it. And also why there is this appetite, I think, at the moment for bigger books, you know, this long-form narrative. We've got a Booker winner this year, which is pretty big. We've got other books on the shortlist that were pretty big too. And we're all into our box sets and our sort of, you know, our long view cultural experiences. And I think this is absolutely one of those. So really good to talk to him about that. So, as I say, link will be in the description below and you can enjoy that at your leisure. I had a couple of copies of the book to give away as well. And I did say that I would try and get him to sign them. I'm a man of my word. He has signed them. So the two lucky people who have got signed copies of City on Fire are Richard James and Katie Clark. Congratulations, both of you. You'll find my email address at the bottom of this video's description. If you could send me your postal address, I'll get those books off to you as soon as I can. Now, this week, I'm staying in America, but I'm going from the East Coast to the West Coast. I'm going to move it forward a few years, and I'm going to go from fiction to non-fiction, because I want to talk about a book that we actually published earlier on this year, but which is now out in paperback and is completely fascinating. Here is the book, Ghettoside by Jill Leovy. So like City on Fire, this is a book which has a shooting in it, and what Jill Leovy does in this book is to take a single case, really, and use it to really look at the police force in America, and in particular in Los Angeles. When we initially published this, it was just after the whole Serial thing had happened. And if you don't know what I mean by the whole Serial thing, Serial was a podcast which went kind of viral, I guess. People really, really latched onto it. It was a true crime non-fiction podcast where a woman called Sarah Koenig was looking at an old murder case, a man called Adnan Syed, who had gone to prison for the murder of his girlfriend, but there was some real doubt about the strength of this conviction, especially because it relied on evidence that was pretty sketchy. And this is all happening at a time before, you know, CCTV cameras and mobile phone records became completely ubiquitous and easy to use in prosecuting murder cases. So there was some really interesting stuff to do there, to interview people who were there at the time, to try and get them to remember what had happened and to really dig deeper and find out whether he was guilty of this crime or not. The case is still actually rumbling on. He is still in prison, but there is some, as I said, some real doubt about that conviction. It's brilliant, brilliant podcasting. So if you haven't listened to it before, go back and listen to it. You can listen to it all now, which is a lovely thing. You don't have to wait, as I did, for the next episode to come along. But the reason why I'm mentioning it is because this book feels very much like the book version of that, taking a single case, really digging deep into the evidence and using it to sort of look at a slightly wider cultural phenomenon, I think, with this book, which is homicide in America, which is black-on-black shooting in particular, and also why so many of these cases weren't being solved by the police. And so what Jill Leovy does is to look at a case of a man called Bryant Tennelle, who was an 18-year-old who was shot, and she also looks at a man called John Skaggs, who was a detective in LA, and who was determined to turn around what he saw as the sort of, the number of cases that were not being solved. And he gets the bit between his teeth and he digs deep. And he really, really, really does proper detective work to try and find out who had shot this boy. That case is completely gripping. And the book itself is fascinating because of the way that it really looks at the wider cultural phenomenon of violence in America, particularly violence within the black community in LA. And why, you know, asking why does it happen? Why are we not prosecuting these cases effectively so that so many murderers are continuing to walk around? What's the cultural phenomenon that's going on here? It's just brilliant. Brilliant, brilliant journalism, brilliant narrative, and brilliant insight into a culture and a world that we all live in still today. Because if you live in a Western democracy, whether you have guns or not, this is about how we all live together and how we segregate people and also how the police do their job. And it feels to me as if this book has become even more relevant than when we initially published it, because, you know, if you look at the news stories that have been coming from America in particular about police work, about police violence and brutality, about shooting, about gun control and gun crime, still such an important thing to be talking about in America. That's why I think this book is even more relevant than it was initially, and a fascinating read. So I just can't recommend it highly enough. It's an easy read, which is the wrong word to use. It's not easy at all. It's hard to read in places because it's difficult stuff. But what I mean is it's beautifully written. It's so clear and so engaging, so that you will be flicking through these pages like it's almost like it's a thriller as you try and sort of find out what is going on. But I think its impact, it happens after you finish reading it, when you really think about how it applies to, as I said, the wider context. So there we go. That is Ghettoside by Jill Leovy, which is a fabulous book. Again, I have a couple of copies to give away. I think it will appeal to people, as I said, who may have enjoyed Serial, or if you're the kind of person who's been enjoying programmes like The Wire. An obvious parallel there. It's that kind of book. So, if you fancy it, make sure you're a UK-based subscriber, leave a comment in the comments below, and I'll pick a couple of winners next week, where I'll be talking about something which isn't in America, which will be certainly in a different country and almost certainly fiction. But I won't tell you anymore. You'll just have to wait and come back next week and find out what it is. But that's all for this week. I'll see you next week. Take care.